In this video, I'm going to demonstrate advanced scroll effects. First, I'll deconstruct this framework project. Here I have a container at a fixed position for my wedges, which are set at absolute. And I've given it a Z index of 4 to place it above the other layers. I'll be animating these wedges using a scroll transform, and to enhance the effect, I've also added a blur. I also have titles that I will animate, text, and these are also within a container set at absolute positioning, and the main container above is set at fixed positioning. The text itself will be relative, and I've done the same for the rest of the titles. And then I've also created scroll triggers with a fixed height set at relative. And I've created 5 of them. These will be used for the scroll transform effect. And here I have a mask, although this is just to blend the video with the background. And then I have a video container set at a fixed height, fixed position, and a video within that set at absolute position. I'll be using a video scroll effect for the video. And then I also have a scroll distance layer for the effect. So I'll close this up and I'll preview this. And if I scroll, nothing happens. So I'm going to add effects. I'll start by animating the first wedge or orange slice. Add a scroll transform. Section in view, I'll choose the viewport centered and scroll trigger 2, not the first one. Set my opacity and scale from and then 2. I'm going to increase the scale. Maybe add a rotation as well. And also set the offset so it goes off screen. And then I'm also going to just adjust this transition, and then I'll preview that. That's fine. I'll do the same for this second wedge, maybe just slightly different. I won't set a rotation now, I'll preview without rotation. Yeah, so without rotation, it's not, doesn't have the same effect, so I'll add a rotation to it as well. So that looks fine. I can adjust the offset scale rotation, but for now that will be fine. and the scroll trigger I used was scroll trigger 2. Next, I'm going to animate the titles. I'll add a scroll transform to the first title, and just as with the wedges, I'll choose the section in view, then choose the scroll trigger 1 this time. Set the opacity and scale. So I've set the from, and I'll set the to. The to will be opacity 1, scale 1, that's fine. And then I'm going to add a transition, adjust the transition. Then I need to add a new section, and this will be the next scroll trigger. And then the effect, I'll make it go to 0, 0, and I'll set an offset. So I want to preview this, but I'll just hide the other text, and then I'll just preview that. So that's fine. I can always adjust the scroll effect, but for now that will be fine. So I'm going to repeat the effect for the other titles, but before I do that, let me just restore the opacity for each one of them. So I select the second title, add an effect, scroll transform, and the options are basically the same. And then I'll add a new section, and the scroll trigger will be 3. And I want to apply the same effect to the rest, so instead of repeating that, I'm just going to copy and then paste. Select the title, go to effects, and then I'll paste. However, I just need to adjust the sections in sequential order. The last title will be different, so I'm going to remove this and then adjust the scale on 2, so it'll be slightly bigger. Right, so I'll preview that. So that's fine. However, I also want the video to animate on scroll, and that I'm going to do next. So to apply the scroll effect, I'm going to need a code override. So I'm going to use the Advanced Scroll Effects by Giles Perry. A link to this template is in the description. So if I view this code, click Edit Code, I'm going to need this section here. However, I'll copy all of the code. Head on over to my project, create a new override, give it a name or title. All right, so I've pasted that. And as mentioned, I just need this section over here, and especially these two values are the ones that I can change. So it's the start Y and the scroll distance. Right, so I'll head on back to my project. I'll select video, then code override, and now I have the option available. And then I'll preview that. Alright, so as simple as that, it works. However, it doesn't quite scroll all the way to the end. So to fix that, I'm going to either adjust my scroll distance here. However, I want to change it here. So I'll set it to 2000 and preview that.